Hello everyone. In this first video on C, we'll be creating a project in MPLAB X and then writing some C code to change an LED on this LED learning center from red to green. So get your fingers warmed up. It's time to write some C code. Now, I know I've done videos on this before, but that was back when I did it using assembly language. And since there are some major differences between C and assembly, I figured starting off with a simple project like this would be a good place to begin. If you haven't already installed MPLAB X and XC8, then please take a few minutes to do that now. And for those of you that have the software ready to go, but no circuit, here's a schematic that will help you build your own circuit so you can follow along. We'll be using LED1 on the LED Learning Center. This LED is a 2-pin bicolor LED that can turn red or green. Now let's go ahead and create a project. Go ahead and start MPLAB X up and then create a new project. Select Microchip Embedded, select Standalone Project, click Next, then either look up the PIC you're using or type in the name here and then select it. Click Next. Select the programmer you're going to use. I'm using the PIC Kit 3. Also, please note that you can't program the PIC 16F1519 with a PIC Kit 2. So if you're using one, you'll have to choose a MCU that can be programmed by the PIC Kit 2. Click Next. Now select the XC8 compiler you wish to use. Now let's name the project LED Blink. To add the main C file to the project, right-click on the Source Files folder and select New, and then C Main File. Name the file LED Blink and click Finish. The file we just created will appear in the editing window. Okay, so now that we have the project set up and our main file ready to go, it's time to start coding. So the first thing we're going to do is configure the configuration bits of our MCU. To do this, click on the Window menu, then select PIC Memory Views, and then select Configuration Bits. A new window will appear down below the main coding window and we'll be able to configure the PIC the way we want it. Now, don't let all these options scare you. We are just going to modify a few things here and leave the rest at the default setting. Change FOSC to INTOSC. This tells the MCU that we'll be using the internal oscillator to drive the MCU. And for the PIC 16F1516, the default internal frequency is 500 kHz. Set the watchdog timer to off. Low voltage programming to off. Now that we have the bits configured, click on the Generate Source Code option. A new window opens up with the generated code that we are going to add to our main file. Press Ctrl+A to select everything and then right-click on the screen and select Copy. Now go back to the main file, right-click and then select Paste. Now that we have the configuration bits set up, we can start writing some code. So let's start with changing our main routine and change the int here to void, since we won't be returning a value when the program ends. And we won't be passing a value to the routine, so let's remove the variables from between the parentheses. Now, let's add in some label declarations, and the first one is define LED1 underscore A, the A stands for anode, LAT B2, and the next one, define LED1 underscore C, the C is for cathode, LAT B3. These are the two port pins that we have this LED tied to. Next up, we'll create our system config routine. This is where I place all commands that will do the initial configuration of the MCU. So type in void system config trisb equals 0. Now add the subroutine LED1 underscore off. LED1 underscore A equal 1. LED1 underscore C equal 1. Now you could also use zeros here as well, but it really doesn't matter. And now let's add in our LED1 green function. Void LED1 underscore green. LED1 underscore A equal 1. LED1_C = 0. Next up, void LED1 red, LED1A = 0, LED1C = 1. Okay, now let's add the code to our main function, and that will consist of the following commands. System_config, while parentheses 1 is double equal 1. Open bracket, LED1 green, wait, LED2 red, wait, LED1 off. Whoops, that LED2 should be LED1. Now we got to create the wait function that we're going to call. So go ahead and go above main and add in void underscore wait underscore underscore delay underscore ms 500. This will tell the processor to wait half a second before changing the color of the LED. Now for this to work correctly, we need to add this declaration that tells the compiler what frequency the MCU will be running at. So everything looks ready, so let's go ahead and compile and program the Learning Center and see how things look. Okay, well, we're getting colors, but the LED isn't turning off, and it should be. Let's see what the problem is. Oh, I see, there's no delay here after the LED went off command. So let's add the delay in and reprogram the PIC. Well, that solved the LED off problem, but the very first color should be green and not red. This means I have the colors reversed, so I need to fix that. So I'm going to cut the code from the red function and paste that into the green function, and then cut the code that was in green and paste that back in red. That'll fix the color reverse issue. Let's recompile and program the PIC. Yeah, that did the trick. That looks much better. The bicolor LED is under control, and we can use this code almost in any situation we want to. That's pretty much it for this video. As always, thanks for watching, take care, and be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe. Write some C code to drive an LED on this display. Oh, almost had it there!